Hey everyone, welcome back to another episode of The Creative Breakthrough. I'm so excited that you guys are all tuning in today. We have a really exciting show today. This week I'm trying something new. I'm going to videotape my opening monologue to post on YouTube. So check it out at youtube.com/funnybrowngirl. So if you're new to the show, what I usually do is I do a quick 5 to 10 minute introduction where I kind of talk about my life, what I've been doing in the creative space, and provide any learnings that I've learned along the way. And then we jump right into the interview. And today we have a really great interview, so stick around. So anyways, like I was saying, usually this is fully an audio podcast, which is available on Spotify, Google Podcast, iTunes, all that good stuff. But this opening monologue will now be available on the YouTube channel. I also wanted to try something different. Next week, I'm going to interview the acclaimed author, Maza Mengiste, the author of The Shadow King, one of New York Times' 100 notable books of 2019. So if you have any questions that you would like me to ask her when I interview her within the next week, please email me at hi@funnybrowngirl.com. Even if you don't have any questions, feel free to email me anyways. I'd love to know your thoughts on how the show is going, what you're learning from it, and anything I can do to help you be better in your creative journey. Okay, as we approach January, I mean, we have a couple days left, I was gonna tell you what my goals were gonna be for 2020. As you know, I have been working on trying to figure out what I wanted my goals to be for 2020 through the month of January, because I just didn't feel ready enough to set goals at the end of 2019. I really just wanted to try some more stuff. So like, I've been going to fringe festivals, I've been going to film writing and film meetings, I've been going to just writing meetings, I've been going to poetry slams. I've just been trying a lot of different stuff, and I wanted to dive deep more into that and what my goals are. And then there's just been so much happening in the news that I wanted to really just talk about what's happening in the news and kind of how that relates to creativity and our journeys in the creative space. A couple people recently have passed away, and both of them have been a shocking death. And the first one that I want to talk about is Professor Clayton Christensen. Now, if you're in the business world, you may have read his books or heard about him. Professor Clayton Christensen is a professor at the Harvard Business School. He's also a business consultant. He's a thought leader. He's a social influencer. His books are about disruptive innovation. And definitely, if you are in the business world and you have not checked out Clayton Christensen, I highly suggest you check out his work. Super, just really smart guy, ahead of his time, really knew what he was talking about. And I read his books. I've studied him in business school. My sister had the opportunity to take a class with him at Harvard Business School. It's just shocking. He was 67 and he passed away. And one of the things that he one time had said, and I'm going to read you something, a message that he had in one of his speeches called "How Will You Measure Your Life?" And it really got me thinking. And so I'm going to read it to you, and then I want to talk to you about like why it got me thinking. "I came to understand that while many of us might default to measuring our lives by summary statistics, such as numbers of people presided over, number of awards, or dollars accumulated in a bank, the only metric that will truly matter to my life are the individuals whom I have been able to help, one by one, to become better people. When I have my interview with God, our conversation will focus on the individuals whose self-esteem I was able to strengthen, whose faith I was able to reinforce, and whose discomfort I was able to assuage. A doer of good, regardless of what assignment I had, these are the metrics that matter in measuring my life." This really hit me hard because I've been so focused on setting goals and talking to you about goals, and people have been writing in about their goals. And it's funny because a lot of our goals are measurable, right? And they always say, make your goals measurable. How many clubs are you gonna perform in this year? How many states are you gonna travel to? How many books are you gonna write? Or even how many pages a day are you gonna write? And we set these measurable goals because people say that's how you can measure if you're actually being successful. And then you've got someone here like Professor Clayton Christensen who's saying, the only metric that really matters is how many people he's been able to help one by one become better people. And that just really got me thinking, like, that's what I want to do. I want to be inspiring to you all. I want to help you all reach your goals. I want to give you that motivation, that inspiration, those strategies. And that's why I interview all these people across the creative space, to give you all that information and that data and that research that you may not have, that mentoring. And so that really puts a whole spin again on what my goals are gonna be for 2020, because this is what I aspire to. We also lost another amazing person in the last couple days, and that's Kobe Bryant. And I know that he's not a legend or a hero or an inspiration to everyone. I know he's had his shortcomings, and I do not, I'm not saying that I overlook his shortcomings when I say that he is an inspiration and I want to talk about him on this podcast, but I do understand that he did not live, he did not have the strongest of values. And I can say that he's been working on that since this incident happened in 2003, but I don't want you guys in any way, shape, or form feel like I am about to say what he did was okay by saying the next piece that I'm gonna say. But I'm a basketball player, and so as a basketball player, I admired him, not only on the court, but off the court, because he always brought his A game. He was just so incredible. He always strived to be better and better in every game. And every time he messed up, he always tried to come back and say, I can do better, I can be better. And that's what I really loved about Kobe Bryant. And one of the things that he said was, I have self-doubt. I have insecurity. I have fear of failure. I have nights when I show up at the arena and I'm like, my back hurts, my feet hurt, my knees hurt. I don't have it. I just want to chill. We all have self-doubt. You don't deny it, but you also don't capitulate it. You embrace it. And these words are just, these words are for everybody, whether you're an athlete or you're a creative. Like, how many times have you felt like you don't want to go to an open mic? You're just so tired, or you don't want to open your journal and write. But you do it. You go ahead and you do these things because you're so passionate about what you do, and you want to get better, and you want to move to the next level, and you want to strive for greatness. And that's what Kobe did. He strived for greatness. Something else that's really inspiring about Kobe was that not only was he amazing on the court, and if you don't know, I mean, he was drafted at the age of 17. He went on to win 5 NBA championships. He played in, he won 4 MVP awards in the All-Star Games, 2 Olympic gold medals. I mean, he's broken multiple records. And then he retired, and he didn't just stop. He didn't just say, okay, I'm retired and I have all this money. He started investing in media. He started investing in technology, consumer goods. He continued to build his global image in China and Europe. I mean, he directed a short film that actually won an Oscar. Did you know Kobe Bryant has an Oscar award? Like, he always wanted to be the best. And he actually was quoted saying, the most important thing is to try and inspire people so that they can be great in whatever they want to do. So really similar message to Clayton Christensen. It's all about, how do you inspire people? And then he also went on to say this in a different interview. The question needs to be, what is my passion? Not where can I create the most value or generate the most revenue, but what is my next passion? When you can find that next passion, everything else will make sense. Again, I'm sure during his career, it was like, how many championships can I win? How many records can I break? How many awards can I win? But as he got older in life, and now that he was coaching his daughter's basketball team, he was invested in the WNBA, he was making all these moves. You see that he changed as a person. It was all about being inspirational. It was all about making a difference. It was all about leaving a legacy. And that's what he's done. He's left a legacy. And that's what I want us all to aspire to, is how do we inspire other people, whether it's through our music, our writing, our comedy, our acting, how do we be more inspiring? And I think that once we figure that piece out, and once we realize, like, this is our passion, it'll all happen and it'll all tie in together. And this has been weighing on me really heavily, because this is what I want to do. Like, this is not this podcast. I mean, this podcast is what I want to do, but like, I want to be an inspiration to people. I want to leave a lasting mark on people's lives. I want people to say that they were able to get X, Y, or Z, or they were able to do X, Y, or Z because Shireen gave them something to help them along their journey. And so that's what I really want to provide for you guys through this podcast. And I really hope that I am doing that. And if there's anything I could be doing better, or anything else that I could be providing to you guys to provide that inspiration, to provide that passion, that learning, please email me at hi@funnybrowngirl.com. I would love to hear from you. Okay, I'm gonna like stop being emotional because I feel like I'm about to cry, and I apologize for that. It's just funny how these people come into our lives and they make these differences, and you don't even realize the difference they've made until they're gone. And it's just, you just wanna say thank you to them for what they did, and you don't get that chance. And so this is to all the people I've lost. Thank you for everything you've taught me along the way. I really appreciate it. And I hope that I can make you proud. Okay, oh my God. The one time I decide to record myself, I start crying. This week we talked to JP Lambiase, a fast food junkie craving the cheapest of cuisines with a disregard to taste. Born in Seoul, South Korea, he was adopted at 6 months, shipped to the US in a fragile box, and has spent his life in pursuit of becoming an entertainer. With the help of his significant other, Julia Gulia, they were both able to accomplish their dreams of becoming YouTubers. JP is the co-founder of the YouTube channel, Healthy Junkfood. Healthy spelled H-E-L-L-T-H-Y, which has over 2.2 million subscribers. Today we learn how to start a successful YouTube channel. So if you aspire to be a YouTube personality, or you're just looking to grow your brand and better understand how to be successful on YouTube, this episode is for you. So what are we waiting for? Let's get started.